Long Swamp is not only locally significant as a really important wetland feature, but it's also listed as a nationally significant wetland in the Directory of Important Wetlands in Australia. It's large, it's in a relatively good condition, and it's known to host a wide range of important wetland species, including a whole host of nationally threatened species. Well, one of the concerns that had been around for some time, particularly among people in the local community, was a trend of change they were observing in the character of the swamp. Species that would normally grow on the dry margins of the wetland were seen to be encroaching the lower lying areas and moving downslope, which was indicative of this drying trend, which has been observed in many wetlands in the region. We were really fortunate that we were invited by the Glenelg Hopkins CMA to become involved in the area in Parks Victoria to undertake, firstly, some investigation work to look at what species occur in the wetland. And what we discovered was that there were some really important remnant pockets of populations of fish and frogs and water birds and important species like that, but that we were finding there were these significant other areas that could be more suitable for aquatic species, those wetland species that were clearly changing as a result of that drying trend.
It's really about recognising those important values, and that the fact that the wetlands and the estuary processes that are working here are working in partnership or working in tune with the existing land uses, and it recognises that people use these wetlands and people use these rivers just as much as the native animals do.
And it also recognises that there's a large contingent of people here and community groups, government agencies that want to see it maintained into the future.
The restoration trial unfolded over 2 years in 3 stages and culminated in the creation of this rather large 7,000 sandbag structure behind us. We worked out it was about 130 days of combined human labour went into building this thing. Dozens of volunteers over about 10 or 12 days spread out over an 8 or 9 week period, and the end result is what you see behind us.
There's a working bee type situation where we put all the sandbags together and had a go. Didn't quite get it the first time, but got it the second time. And it was wonderful to see so many people doing it. And we're very proud of that.
I'm enjoying seeing the added water. It wasn't very enjoyable lugging sandbags and you know, my knees still haven't recovered from that.
We've got about 200 hectares of wetland immediately upstream that is being directly influenced by the level set by this structure. So in the context of a 1,000 hectare wetland system, it's a significant proportion. But perhaps more importantly, as a result of getting that level right, what we're also seeing is more water being tipped downstream. Those additional flows and connectivity through the system are really important for the health of the wetland and for the species that live in it, and we're seeing that directly play out in the monitoring results. Our fish monitoring, which has been supported by the Glenelg Hopkins CMA, has allowed us to detect changes that are happening in the water. And what we've found in the most recent round of monitoring is that 2 of our nationally threatened fish species are actually in the wetland just behind the structure now. They weren't there before, and that's as a direct result of the works that have happened. A wide range of other environmental attributes are improving before our very eyes. We're seeing changes in the vegetation composition, and a shift towards conditions that are more conducive to our wetland species doing really well. We've seen nationally threatened wetland birds return to the area.
The culmination of that is, yes, it's functioning. It's the species are here that want to make this place their home, and it's coexisting with the surrounding land uses that we have in the area.
Long Swamp is back to where it should be in the first place. Had a lot of water in there, and the eels are growing in there, the frogs and all the little creatures that live in these freshwater inlets, they're happily in there.
It's a case of trying to give the planet something back, and mankind's just leeching from the planet constantly. And if we can preserve an area and even improve an area and bring it back to something like what it was pre-European settlement, I think that's all for the betterment of the environment, for the betterment of the planet, and it'll be there for our kids and our grandkids and our great-grandkids and generations to come.